In the darkness of exile, they had a beacon of hope. A dream about a place they belonged to. It led them across the seas and oceans and brought them here to build the first Hebrew city. Hard times befall the Jews of Europe. Anti-Semitism and violent pogroms make their life unbearable. And so, brave pioneers leave the world they know behind to embark on a revolution. A 100 years have passed. It's time for us to follow in their path, to see what became of their dream. After all, this journey is all about vision. No. 66 families gather on the sand dunes north of Jaffa. They're conducting a lottery for the plots they had purchased here. Mayor Dizengoff, who will become the first mayor of the city, speaks at the cornerstone ceremony of Achuzat Bayit. He knows they are making history.
Achai, anachnu menichim po even hapina liyisod shkunat Achuzat Bayit hi Tel Aviv. Yabo yom, even zot mikir tisak. Atem ratitem vein zot aguda.
Forefathers of Tel Aviv. They conceived the idea to leave Jaffa and build a new city run by Jews, the first Hebrew city in modern history. Before there was a city, the city had neighborhoods. Sephardic and Yemenite Jews established first habitats outside of Jaffa. Neve Tzedek, Shabazi, and the Yemenite Vineyard Quarters. The old charm of this district makes it a fashionable spot for shops, cafes, and artist studios. The name Tel Aviv is mentioned for the first time in the Bible, as the city in Babylon where Ezekiel, the exiled prophet, saw a vision of dry bones coming to life. The name is later chosen as a translation of Theodor Herzl's novel Altneuland. It means old new land. Aviv is the Hebrew word for spring, symbolizing renewal. Tel stands for the treasures of the past. Together, they represent Herzl's great design, the Renaissance of the Jewish homeland.
Thank you. תל אביב הייתה עיר של חולות. מעל החולות התחילו לצמוח בניינים. ולאט לאט התחילו לקום הקוביות, הצורות הפשוטות, הגיאומטריות, ולאט לאט נוצרו רחובות, נוצרה עיר, העיר הלבנה. הבתים הלבנים קבעו את הכלל. אלה היו בתים שבנו אותם אדריכלים שבאו מאירופה, והביאו אותם את הסגנון הבינלאומי. אנשים שבאו להנה רצו ליצור חיים אחרים, חיים פשוטים, חיים לא מקושטים. אנשים הלכו בלי עניבות, אנשים הלכו בחולצות פתוחות, ובמכנסיים קצרים, בסנדלים, על החולות, יחייפים. בעצם אני גיליתי את היופי די מאוחר. פתאום ראיתי שיש לנו פה אוצר שצריך לשמר אותו. אני מסתכל על הפרטים, על הפשטות, על הצורות, איך שצורה מתחברת עם צורה, איזה תשומת לב. אני רואה את האושר של הדברים האלה, וכשאני משווה אותם לדברים הנפלאים שמשמרים אותם בחוץ לארץ, עם גדולי השמות, כמו לקורבוזיה וכמו מיס ואן דה רוי, אני רואה שהדוגמאות שישנם כאן הן מדהימות ביופיין.
Tel Aviv's White City. It was nominated by UNESCO in 2003, a World Cultural Heritage Site, recognizing the outstanding architectural ensemble of the modern movement, created in a new cultural context. In his vision, Herzl pictures the founding of an independent Jewish state, a model society, utilizing science and state-of-the-art technology to enhance its development, an open and prosperous society, where the Jewish spirit will shine a light unto the nations.
I first came to Tel Aviv at the age of 25 in 1961, and suddenly was thrust into this Middle East situation, Tel Aviv. Lots of people on the streets, lots of bustling, everybody's going somewhere, doing something, arguing, discussing. And I felt at home immediately. Tel Aviv has avenues constructed by the old Europeans who founded the city. They wanted avenues like in Bucharest or in Paris or in Berlin. So you have Rothschild Boulevard, Chen Boulevard, Ben Gurion Boulevard, with parks in the middle of the road. These parks have become places of amusement. I mean, I don't take part in it because I have concerts every single night, but going home, I see what's going on Rothschild Boulevard, and it lifts my heart because it never used to be. Tel Aviv culturally has more to offer than most European or American cities, because you have a great world-class orchestra, you have a wonderful opera house, you have theater, and then there are galleries. If you open a newspaper on Friday and look at the art and culture section, you're amazed, page after page after page of galleries announcing the openings, of theaters having premieres, of the Philharmonic that announces their season every year. We go on tours also. We take Israel abroad. We show the positive face of Israel to Buenos Aires and to Tokyo. There's a lot going on here.
Tu vuoi venire alla moda, ma se beve whisky and soda, poi da sempre disturbato. Guardando il rock and roll, tu giochi al festival, hai soldi in bank a me, chi devi dare la tua seta di mamma. Tu vuoi fare americano, 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 ma sei nato in Italia, siendo me non c'è sta niente va, ok Napoli. Tu vuoi fare America, tu vuoi fare americano, americano, americano. Che non è di troppo fa. Tu vuoi vivere alla moda, ma si bevi whisky e soda. Poi ti sento di stufare. Tu vuoi fare rock and roll, tu giochi a baseball. Ma i soldi venga a me, chi te li dà? La presenza di mamma. Tu vuoi fare americano.
Legendary David Ben-Gurion. The first prime from these modest rooms, Ben-Gurion struggled to found. He took pride in his library, the perfect expression of the spirit of the people of the book.
על הקמת מדינה יהודית בארץ ישראל, היא מדינת ישראל.
תל אביב ג'פה belongs to everyone who lives in it. It's fun to grow up in the city. It makes you feel at home when you grow old. Lily and her friends who survived the Holocaust escaped to Tel Aviv to rebuild their lives. They come here every year to their favorite traditional cafe to commemorate their freedom. It's a pluralistic city, devoted to educating its variety of populations. We believe the way to adjust society is through knowledge.
נולדתי ברוסיה. הייתי בן שנה, עברנו לרואנדה, לאפריקה. בגיל 12 עלינו לארץ. פה סיימתי את התיכון, במהלך התיכון למדתי כאן בחמדה. היום אני מהנדס כימיה, מהנדס תהליך במתקן ייצור. נחמד לבוא לפה ולראות מאיפה כל זה התחיל בעצם, מאיפה בחרתי את המקצוע הזה ומאיפה עבר למקצוע, כל יום אני מתלהב מכדור. נורא באמת פחדתי וחששתי בהתחלה. ארץ זרה ושפה חדשה, את העברית, הכתוב בעברית, שאני בכלל לא מבין אף אות שכתובה שם, זה משהו שרואים פעם ראשונה. אמרתי, וואי, עד שאני אלמד את כל האותיות, וואי, מה זה השפה הזאת והכל.
Hebrew, the language of the Bible and the prayers, never spoken freely before, enjoys a surprising revival by Eliezer ben Yehuda, who aims to breathe new life into the ancient tongue. In 1911, the Herzliya Hebrew Gymnasium is founded, the first high school ever to teach using the Hebrew language. Tel Aviv quickly becomes a capital of cultural life, a city of intellectuals, artists, writers, poets, and journalists, a symbol of the rebirth of the Hebrew culture. The next generation of visionaries is being raised here. They will be the ones who take us to the future. To this day, this city is a marriage of Jewish heritage and Israeli innovation. That is the essence of the Tel Aviv spirit. The power of a vision to create and evolve into something new, while still maintaining the old, is instilled in the city's DNA. All this in just 100 years. What lies ahead is still unknown. The work has only begun. But don't worry. After all, these people are never done. And once you've felt the spirit of this place, you know in your heart that the future will be today's vision coming true.